In this video, I'll show you how we painted our race car in the garage and achieved a really professional looking result using just a basic spray gun, a really sketchy rotisserie, and a lot of prep work. But before we could paint the car, we had to finish up all the sheet metal work on the body. First, we made a new floor for the trunk area. We cut out our steel sheets from cardboard templates, rolled some beads into them to add some stiffness and make them look sweet, and then welded them in. After the floor was finished, we blocked off the larger holes on the firewall and moved on to the last gussets we required on the cage. We're building the cage to FIA specifications, so we need these gussets on the main cross, the door bars, and the windscreen pillar reinforcements. After we finished the main cross and door bar gussets, we sanded and scuffed as much of the interior as we could, and then took the car outside to clean it out. The windscreen pillar reinforcement gussets were kind of a tricky shape, so we took some measurements and made a CAD model, printed it out to test the fit, and had the gussets plasma cut out. Then they were easy to form by hand over some roll cage tubing into the final form, and fit really nicely with minimal gaps. We also added some bosses into the cowl that we will thread later for the hood latches we'll be using. Then with some last minute sanding, we were ready to really start prepping the car for paint. The first thing we wanted to paint was the underside of the car, which meant first we had to flip it on its side in a super safe manner.
Oh god. Oh god. Oh god.
We didn't even die. Oh. Look at all this access.
Man. And
huh.
We got a lot of sand out.
I heard that. That just means there's...
We spent a while with the vacuum cleaner and compressed air trying to blow out all the sandblasting media that was still in the car, and then we had to wire wheel off a bunch of undercoating. Then it was time to turn the garage into a Dexter room. We're using a two-component epoxy primer, and on the underside of the car, we're only painting the areas we need to. So after we finished painting the underside of the car, we were brainstorming about how to mount the fuel filter and the lines and all that, and it was at that point that we realized the previous owner had cut off all the stock fuel tank mounts. Better now than later, but this was really annoying. So we had to remake the mounts to use the stock fuel tank straps. When that was taken care of, we seam sealed all the seams and flipped the car back over to do the final preparations before laying down the epoxy primer. After some more sanding and vacuuming, I wiped all the surfaces down with acetone and we were ready to start spraying. We're painting the car a BMW Alpine White, and luckily we had paint left over that came with the car when we bought it. When putting on the primer, we learned that getting coverage into all the nooks and crannies of the cage was really hard to do. So before we started spraying the paint, we spent some time with brushes to get into all the really hard to reach areas. In the end, I think this ended up saving us a lot of time and drips from trying to get coverage in those areas. And then to start out, Mike sat in the car and sprayed the ceiling and all the parts that were really tricky to access from outside the car. After two coats of paint, this is how the car turned out. I have to say, we're really happy with the result, considering neither of us had painted a car before. It turned out way better than we expected. And since we had the shell completely bare without even a single bolt, we took the opportunity to weigh it and find the center of gravity. So our bare shell with the cage weighs 309 kilograms. Next on the list will be finishing up the engine systems. We need to convert the oil pan to rear sump and fabricate our intake manifold. After that, we'll be focusing on the cooling and fuel systems. Stay tuned for more updates.